you know, not a lot, not too much you can say about a game like that. I mean, they're just a really, really good team, really tough place to play. And, you know, I think I told Macy as she was walking out, I liked her a lot better when she was injured. But, you know, the fact that she's improved as a basketball player through an ACL injury is just really impressive. And they're so well-rounded. And honestly, you have to play a near-perfect game here to even give yourself a chance to win, and we were far from perfect. I mean, the very first possession, I think we missed a wide-open layup. That's probably the most air balls, air banks, forcing into traffic we've probably done all year, and it just kind of builds on you. So overall, I mean, I told them we didn't have to win here to necessarily accomplish all of our goals. It would have been a huge thing to do to pick up a game with teams in the conference, but, you know, Oklahoma couldn't come in here and win. Louisville could barely come in here and win, and now we see why.
Just a bad night for you guys, Coach. I mean, obviously the Jacks were good, but I have to assume you would have liked a better showing from your team.
Yeah, I would have. And I'm sure part of that is them, part of that is us. I mean, they've defended us well. I think we've only played one what I would consider good basketball game here. A couple years ago, actually, when we were not as good, we played tremendous, and it kind of went right down to the wire. But last year we were a little more competitive. They got on us early, and then we kind of battled back to make it respectable, but it still wasn't a close game. So seems like they've defended us really well. But, yeah, mentally we just can't figure out how to not let the wheels fall off the wagon when things get going. And I don't know if it's the pressure of you feel like if you make a couple mistakes, then they're going to get going and bury you in a minute or two, or if we're rushed or if the atmosphere bothers us. But I obviously haven't quite figured it out.
They're kind of on a run defensively right now where they've strung together a lot of good games defensively, and it seems like they're better defensively than they've been in the past. Do you see something that they're doing differently or just doing better on that side of the ball?
They're really good defensively, and I do agree, even a step up. I've thought they've always been a good defensive team. They use our length so well. They help and recover so well. I think they're Tegan Larson, I think, really gives them something defensively because she moves so well. Against a team like us who maybe because we play five perimeter players have had a little bit of advantage against some of their bigs in the past that didn't move quite as well as her. But, you know, they made every single thing difficult. I told our girls in the locker room, like, I'm sorry I didn't have an answer for you offensively, which, you know, I've got a little bit of a reputation of an offensive coach, and usually I feel like I've got some, you know, some pretty good solutions to our problems, but it just seemed like whatever we did wasn't working.
Would you have liked to, 38 threes out of 61 shots, were there times that you tried to go inside or would have liked to try to go inside more?
You know, it's just awfully tough. I mean, we get points around the basket in games because we extend the defense shooting three-pointers. So when we're not shooting threes and they don't feel like they have to respect that as much, it makes it even more difficult to get things around the basket. I mean, we really don't have anyone that likes to post up. You know, Morgan Bloomer probably is our closest thing to someone who likes to score with their back to the basket. And sometimes she has a smaller guard on her. But, you know, even if you're being guarded by one of their guards, they're going to be equal size to Morgan. So I would have liked to hit a few more threes, and I think that would have opened up some things at the basket. But even from that first possession when we did get – I mean, I know we had a couple good offensive movements, and we missed three absolute point-blank wide-open layups, you know. So it just seems like then everything gets tight and everything gets tough.
Well, they'll play South Dakota now on Thursday, and everyone is kind of going to make that out to be the big game in the Summit League. Can your team still – is there still time for you to get back into the picture with those two?
You know, I think that a lot of people are thinking it's a kind of a two-dog race, so to speak, two-horse race. And I think that's fair. I mean, with what South Dakota did to us at our place and our performance here, I think the positive for us is we've always been the underdog, and we really like that role. And I think we've battled this year, being someone who I would not say we were the favorite in the league, but, you know, someone who was kind of expected to be really good and challenged for that championship. And so I think the fact that we're probably getting counted out a little bit after, you know, two losses, I think can hopefully inspire our team. I mean, last year we should have been 4-4 in that first round through conference. We snuck out a miracle win at Omaha to go 5-3 through that first round of conference. So then we kind of got hot and rattled some things off. So I know that's still possible, but the top half of the league is really, really good this year, and we're just kind of trying to survive it.